then the, so and so on. Then 1990s, body was lost. Then they called 10 years last year, began in 1990s. Then we have had the third oil crisis. Then 2007 summer, subprime loan crisis attacked Japan. Subprime loan crisis. Did you have the big damage in your country, your Ghanaian economy had a big damage? This subprime loan crisis attacked very severely Japanese economies. Subprime loan means American bank let so much money to poor people. Then poor people lost a job, so they couldn't pay back the money. Then American huge investment bank such as Lehman Brothers got bankrupt. That is a subprime loan crisis. Then 2008 December, world monetary crisis began. Then again, this is Greece shock. 2010 spring, everybody must know the Greek shock. Then the value of euro is becoming weak and weak. Then again, nowadays, last year, last month, an appreciation has been prevailing all over the Japan. That is very, very severe problem. Today, $1 is just only 81 yen. If we like to have some economic growth, we must keep $1 is 100-150. Otherwise, Japanese manufacturing companies cannot compete with the manufacturing goods made in U.S. So that's why the yen appreciation is very, very big problem for the Japanese economy. This is, I'm going to tell you that transition of hegemony. In the 19th century, Pax Britannica was quite famous. Then after them, Pax Americana. Before and after World War II, also Bretton Woods system played favor for the Pax Americana. Then mass production, mass consumption, of course, dollar became the key currency for the world transaction. So American had the big advantage because the USA dollar became the key currency. However, after Vietnam War, and like I mentioned, they have a double deficit. Then Pax Americana disappeared. Then after 1965, we say Pax Japanica appeared until 1995 when we had Plaza Agreement. Then also Pax Japanica has disappeared. Now people would say Pax Chinica. I don't know this English good or not. Pax Chinica in the second half of the 21st century would be appearing in the world economy. Of course, there are some conditions. for them to have pax cinica. One is, like I mentioned here, if the government of China could maintain so-called the double systems, that means their political system is purely communism. However, since they joined the WTO, their economic system is capitalism. In the world history, no country could survive with dual systems. So we economists sometimes forecast, maybe you don't like it or not, I'm Japanese, so I can tell, maybe 50 years later, if they cannot keep the dual systems, I'm sure the country of China going to be the similar country like Soviet Russia. That means small prohibition, small other states might want to get separated from the center of China. That is the point. Like me, economist has been forecasting. That is a very weak point for China. That's why we really don't know how long Pax Cinica could stay with us. Of course, huge population. Point is, another point is for them, strong renminbi. At this moment, G20 monetary conference going to be held at this moment. Then President Obama of the United States strongly asking the Chinese government to appreciate yuan against USA dollar. However, the Prime Minister of China refused it. But no, as economists, we really don't think they keep that for the exchange rate, present for the exchange rate against USA dollar for 3 years. Maybe Chinese renminbi have become appreciated USA dollars. Then Pax Cinica will disappear. Also, the country of China has been considered to be the world factory. So many Japanese manufacturing companies such as Toyota, Honda, huge every companies has been out of Japan to have their own factory in China because of the cheap labor, because of very cheap land price. However, if renminbi has strong appreciated so much, I really don't know. We Japanese factory could stay in China or not. Maybe the 5 years. After then, Japanese companies going to Vietnam and Thailand, something like this.